Imagine going into your office and opening up your email inbox and seeing that it is completely organized, that everything has been replied to, that it's pretty much empty. Well, if you want this in your business, you're in the right place, because I'm going to show you how to make that a reality. Hey, I'm Jen Lehner. I'm a digital marketing and systems strategist, and I help people grow their businesses by outsourcing the smart way and using smart systems. Handing my inbox over to my virtual assistant was the last thing I actually ever did. It was the last big step I ever took in my journey as someone who's working with a team. And I really wish it was one of the first things that I did, because it's just not as scary as you might think. And in this video, I'm gonna break it all down for you step by step, and make sure you stay till the end, because I'm gonna share with you this awesome free tool that I just recently found that's going to make the whole process that much easier. Okay, first of all, it's important to know that when you share your inbox, you want to be sharing your business email. Okay, so I don't share my personal email. My personal email stays personal. Been a little bit careless and you've been sort of lumping both into one account. From here on out, make sure that you only give your personal email address to people, to things that are related to your personal life, and business email to things that relate to your business. Okay, so just moving forward, you're gonna wanna make sure and do that. When I say business email, it's the .com, okay? So you wanna secure an email like that, and you can do that through Gmail, and Gmail's used to be called G Suite, and it's Workspace now. So mine is jennifer@jenlehner.com. So that's number one. Number two is you need to understand that, let go of the fear that your VA is going to delete something that's important. First of all, if something is really important, it's gonna show up again. So we really need to just let that go. And the second thing is, there is an archive option, which I'm gonna show you now, that means that it disappears from your inbox, but if you ever needed to call it back up again, you could find it with an easy search. So let me show you the archive option. The best way for me to demonstrate this is to actually go inside the social tab in my personal email account, because these are all emails that can be deleted. So what I'm going to do is I am going to click this box up in the top left-hand corner. And now, this is very important when you're doing something like this. If you want to empty out an entire folder, then this only selected the first 50 conversations. If I click over here where it says select all 220 or 223 conversations, it will do that. So now I've got everything in this social folder. And by the way, if you have a social tab, all of this stuff can get deleted, because these are just notifications from your social media channels. In fact, you could do away with this tab altogether if you wanted to. So we've selected all of these emails. And the next thing that we're gonna do is, now I'm totally okay with deleting all of these. I never need to see them again. But what I'm trying to demonstrate to you is that if you archive them, I'm gonna click archive, and all of these are now being archived and they're gone, except for these two promotions, paid promotions in my folder. Now, what if I accidentally archive something? No big deal, because all I have to do is come in here and type in whatever the word was or something from an email that I'm looking for, and it'll pop right back up. Okay, so that's your safety net. So you wanna make sure and just show your VA that if there's something in question about deleting it, you could show your VA the things that always get deleted. You know, you could show your VA what spam looks like, but if there's ever any question, you can just show this person that they are to archive it, not to delete it. Or you could just make that a rule across the board. Just say, you know, don't ever delete anything, but let's archive it instead. Now let's go back into my inbox so I can show you the rest of the way. All right, this is my inbox. And as you can see, this main area here in front of us is sort of the main inbox. We'll call that the catch-all. And then to the right, Gen follow-up, awaiting reply, delegated, and to read. And normally this inbox is never this full, but I wanted to leave it like this so that I could do this demo for you. So what happens is whenever, like if Nika comes in here first, Nika is my VA, she comes in here first, she'll go through all the email and sort it out according to what needs to be done. So for example, here's a meeting with Allison, and let's see, let me unstar that. So if Nika wants to make sure that I don't miss this, she's going to put a yellow star. And as you could see over here on the right, after I refresh, the thing is I'd already done it, but normally you would refresh, you'd hit refresh up there, and then you would see it over here in the Gen follow-up column. And you could see there's the email right there. After that, Nika can safely archive this by clicking that button right there. And remember, archive deletes it for all intents and purposes, because you'll never see it again unless you want to, and you could call it up right there by searching conversations right up there. So let's look at something else. Here we have an email from the Daily Stoic. Well, this is a blog that I like to read. It's an email I like to read, so Nika knows that, and so she will click it and click it again until a blue little square appears, okay? Once that happened, now look over here on the bottom right. I'm going to hit reload. And when I hit reload, there it is. Now it showed up. You see there? So then Nika can take it and archive it. Now, if I get here first and I see something that needs to get delegated, that's something that Nika or someone else on our team needs to take care of, then I would go over here, click until I see that little red icon right there, the little red arrows. And then you guessed it, it shows up here. After I hit reload, it's going to show up here in the delegated section. Okay, let's look at some other ones. So let's pretend that I'm awaiting a reply from this person. I'm going to click until I see the purple question mark. It's something that needs to be followed up on. And then that's going to put it, let's hit reload so you can see where this goes. And you'll see that it's right there. Well, actually, at the beginning of the day, when I log in, this area here is usually completely empty. Now, how do you set up your inboxes to look like this? Well, follow me. First thing that we're going to do is click on that cogwheel in the upper right-hand corner, and we're going to click See All Settings. And the next thing you want to do is go here to where it says Inbox. Then you want to make sure right here on the drop-down box, this drop-down menu, that you select multiple inboxes. And then you want to copy this and label it to suit your business needs. So you could see here, section one has yellow star, section two has purple question, and so on and so forth. And you could just pause the video here so you can type this out. And then you can label this how you want. So we have Gen follow-up, awaiting reply, delegated to read, but maybe you want different categories. That's completely up to you. We've got it to show 9 conversations per page for the multiple inbox sections. And then we've checked right multiple inbox position right of the inbox. You can test out the others, but this is what we're using. And skip this, leave that unchecked where it says reading pane. Importance markers, you're going to check no markers. Then we have used my past actions to predict which messages are important to me. And then we have filtered mail, don't override filters. Okay. Now you want to go back to settings, and this time you're going to go to general, and then you're going to go to stars, which is right here. Okay. And then you just drag the star up into the in use section. And then if you want to learn the name of each star to type into that box we saw earlier, you just hover over it. So these are the icons that we're using and the stars, but obviously you could choose whatever you want. So now you might be saying, well, great, Jen, but how in the world is my VA supposed to know what I want to read later and what is necessarily important or is important? Well, that's just going to be part of your training, and it's just not as complicated as you might think that it is. And again, remember, if something is deleted by accident, it's never really deleted, it's going to be archived, and if it's really important, it's going to show up again. So don't worry about that. Okay, now this is the new tool that I discovered that is so cool because it allows you to communicate with your VA right there on the email itself. And this is good for training purposes and just really making sure to stay on the same page, literally. So I really, really love this. Check it out. This brand new tool that is so cool that allows you to sort of train in process as you go, okay? Because even for us, like, new things will pop up and there are comments that I want to make in terms of, like, from now on, let's make sure these emails go here or whatever. So let me just show you what I mean. I want to show you this fantastic Gmail extension. So what you're going to do is open up a new tab in Chrome. Then you want to go to this colorful grid up at the top left that says apps. Click on that. Then click on web store. You could probably also just Google Chrome web store. And then we're going to search for simple Gmail notes. And there it is up at the top. And I've already added it, so I can't add it again, but just click through and add it and you'll be good to go. And let me show you how it works. We'll go to my friend Miriam. All right, so look up here. Do you see the yellow box that's up at the top? Okay, this is so cool. So I can say, hey Nika, let's make sure and add this to our resources folder. Also, please forward this to, I'm making up a name, Sally, and tell her we have a free pass. Okay, that literally makes no sense based on the context of this email. But the point is, we could communicate with each other on this email. The other thing is, in our support email, which is run by my team, everybody has their own email account, we could do the same thing. So if I want Nika to reply a certain kind of way, I can literally put what I want her to say in this highlighted area, which makes it so much easier for her, as opposed to forwarding an email or having to make a Voxer call or posting on the Trello board. It takes care of it right here. So this is what it looks like now. Do you see? See how that note shop popped up? So now Nika sees that, she clicks into it, and she could see the notes up at the top. She can also add her own notes. So that's it. Now you should be feeling super confident about working with someone in your inbox. Trust me, it's going to make your life so much easier. It's going to free up so much of your time. So give it a try and then comment down below and let me know how it goes. And if you enjoyed this training, make sure you like and subscribe and click the little bell thingy so you get an alert whenever I do one of these trainings so you never miss one. All right, see you soon.